Had a first video last week, and I thought that maybe next video should not be as formal or with as set big setup. It could be a very simple video, learning astrology fact without getting into too many details, and something very interesting, something very, what you say, sometimes it's mysterious also, but very interesting also. So everybody knows there are 12 signs, so, and everybody talks about the Rashi Swami, like owner of some sign or Rashi, and people mostly know Rashi Swami. What is the Rashi Swami? So everybody knows 12 signs, 12 Rashi. Mesh, Vrishabh, Mithun, Karka, Sinha, Kanya, Tula, Vrishchik, Dhanu, Makar, and Kumbha and Meen. And Rashi Swami, for that everybody knows Rashi Swami for that. So Mesh Rashi Swami is Mangal, Vrishabh Rashi Swami is Shukra, Mithun Rashi Swami Buddha, Karka Rashi Swami Chandra, Sinha Rashi Swami is Surya, Kanya is Buddha, Tula is Shukra, Mangal again for Vrishchik, Dhanu is Guru, Makar, Kumbha, two Rashi consecutive are Shani owned, and Meen Rashi is Guru owned. Meen Rashi is also co-owned by Neptune, and Kumbha Rashi is co-owned by Uranus. And now that is modern interpretation. It is not in any of the books, especially Vedic astrology books. They don't have Neptune and Uranus. But yeah, modern, we have observed that Kumbha Rashi is modern. Kumbha Rashi is lateral thinker like Uranus, and Meen Rashi is innovative, imaginative, sixth sense, and it has a depth of Neptune, Neptunian characteristics. So what is the meaning of this Rashi Swami? Rashi Swami, like simply speaking, let's say your Rashi is Vrishchik, and also let's say somebody else has Vrishchik Lagna Rashi and first house Mangal. So they will also have those characteristics of Vrishchik Rashi. So Mangal in Mesh Rashi and Chandra in Mesh Rashi, there are common characteristics. So you can easily see that. So that's why Rashi Swami can be easily proven by case studies. But everything is mysterious about astrology. Similarly, if you look at Rashi Swami, how they are assigned. Now they are not assigned. If they are assigned or they have turned out that way. But if you see, case studies prove that Rashi Swami are correct. So now if you look at Rashi Swami, Karka Rashi Swami is Chandra, and Sinha Rashi Swami is Surya. So these Chandra and Surya are not like, Surya is not a planet, Chandra is not a planet, like. So if you look at one sign before Karka Rashi, Mithun, and one sign after Sinha Rashi, Kanya. Mithun and Kanya is owned by Buddha, and Buddha is next to Surya, is the first planet, interior planet to the Surya. Similarly, just go one back from Mithun Rashi is Vrishabh Rashi, one go forward from Kanya Rashi is Tula Rashi. Tula and Vrishabh are owned by Shukra. Shukra is after Buddha, right? From the sun, away from the sun. And again, go one back, you have Mesh Rashi, and one forward from Tula is Vrishchik. So Mesh and Vrishchik is owned by Mangal. Mangal is again further after Earth. Mangal is the next in line. Now go one back, Mesh Rashi is first Rashi, so back is Meen Rashi. And after Vrishchik Rashi, there is Dhanu Rashi. So Dhanu Rashi and Meen Rashi is owned by Guru. Guru is after Mangal. Again, go one back from Meen Rashi is Kumbha Rashi. One go forward from Dhanu Rashi is Makar Rashi. Makar and Kumbha are both owned by Shani, which is after Guru. So you can call it a mysterious arrangement, or you can call it a coincidence, mysterious mysticism, or simply you can think that our zodiac, the zodiac is defined by sun, movement of sun with respect to earth, where we see sun from the earth, that is zodiac. Those signs have the characteristics of planets of our solar system. Now think over this sentence. Means your Lagna Rashi is Vrishchik, or your Chandra Rashi is Vrishchik. You have similar characteristics, some characteristics, not all, quite a bit commonality. So what that means is that our zodiac, which is, if you look at zodiac stars, Vrishik Rashi, those stars are light years away from Earth, and they are still going away. Those stars are going away from the Earth. It is ever expanding universe. But that zodiac, those 12 signs mimic in the same double quotes, mimic the characteristics of the planets of our solar system, which is very close to the Earth, which is of course bound to each other, exerting forces on each other, all these bodies, solar system bodies. So all these planets are part of our solar system. They embody, or they have the characteristics of those signs which are millions of light years away, whatever light years away. The red effect, you can read red effect, you can Google red effect, how those stars are going away from the they are going away, like they are ever expanding universe, they are going away. So it is very mysterious fact how these signs, how these planets mimic those signs, but in the sequence, whereas you look at one sign back and one sign forward, owned by the same planet. And what is owned by the same planet? It is observed in practice. It's not like somebody has assigned it. Nobody has assigned it, here Rashi Swami. It is found in practice. It is found daily usage in case studies. So that is, you can call it mysterious arrangement. You can call it a great coincidence, or you can call it a God's creation, Brahmand creation from Brahma. Only Brahma can answer this to us. Okay, not, we can't explain it. Similarly, Mahadasha, why 120 years, why each planet gets so many years? There is no logical explanation. There is some explanation on the internet you will find, but again, why that way? Nobody is able to answer that. So we'll take one topic at each time, but right now I just wanted to deal with this mysterious arrangement, 12 signs, their ownership and their sequencing, how they get aligned to our solar system, the signs which themselves are way away from like ever expanding universe. They are not a part of our solar system, but still our solar system mimics that zodiac. It's amazing. Thanks.